knows about your problem, it has to come to an end. You've got now to seek him.
That's it.
Take an extra mile.
Amen.
And hear what the Lord is saying about your situation. You see, with the issues of prayer, that people like Esther, look at Esther. She had to call for a fast. The situation was getting bad. But she didn't go backwards. She said, if I perish, let me perish. I'm calling for a fast, dry fasting 3 days. We want God to move. The Jews can't be killed. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Prayer is the key. In the name of Jesus. And when you look at another woman, the Shunammite woman, you know, this woman was a woman who honored servants of God. She built a house upstairs for Elisha to come and sleep as he was ministering. Yet she, in her heart, she wanted a child, she wanted a son. But instead of being in prayer and fasting and doing everything to say, Lord, I want, she just doing the act, and she said, I'm going to touch the Lord through honoring his servant. And through that, the Lord remembered her. And Elisha asked his servant, what can be done to this woman? You know, these people have got a blessing for us. I know sometimes it's not understood in this nation, but it's here. It's not about the environment.
Amen.
Servants of God, they do have a blessing in them. Being servants whom God has called for his
Amen.
Work. Honoring them, which we have been taught time and again, you can see even the results in the word of the Lord.
Amen.
Through honoring a servant of God, the Shunammite woman got her son, her child. Because when Gehazi was asked, he said, you know what? She doesn't have a son. She doesn't have a child. And Elisha said, next year, time like this, you'll be holding a son.